Well, this is our first concert, so I'm hoping that the next one we have that you will invite many, many more people. Today's concept is love, and we're going to see all different kinds of love. We're going to see love triangles, we're going to see people willing to go to their death for love. We're going to see incestuous love. So it's going to be a very interesting and varied program. There are notes in the program on each piece that we're doing. We're having a couple of changes in the program, and I will announce them as they happen. And I may have the artist come up and give a synopsis of what they're singing about if I have not received a synopsis from them. Otherwise, I will tell you what they're singing about, and then they'll just begin singing, okay? So our first selection is going to be from the Kissing Band in the movie from the 40s with Katharine Grayson. It's Love Is Where You Find It. going to have a little change in the program. Espal Rivas is going to sing an art song on the theme of love, and he will take a moment and tell you a little bit about the composer and what is being said in the song, and then he'll start singing.
This song is called Te Quiero Dijiste. It means, I love you, you said. And in this song is from the composer Maria Riven. And this song, it's talking about a person, what this person that means a lot to you had declared. And at the same time, you're describing what you're feeling, but also how this person makes you feel.
Yeah.
hear the Otello duet today, and we're not going to hear the Rigoletto, but we will hear a beautiful aria from Turandot. This is an aria that she sings just prior to committing suicide because she's been asked by Turandot and by the members of the chorus who support her that they want her to release the name of the unknown prince because he has asked for her hand in marriage and she is fearful of taking that hand because of something that had happened to her friend Princess Laoling before the opera even takes place. So this is Liu's last act aria just before she commits suicide. We're going to hear Juliet's entrance aria before the duet, O Quanta Volte. That's what she's preparing for, and then the Romeo will come out. We're going to have a little change in the program. We're going to do the Wagner first, before the Chenier. So Wagner's Devoutry Duet.
Thank you. Thank you.
mission. I don't think we need to take a full 15 minutes because there's not a huge crowd here to get to it from the bathrooms. So we'll probably take a slightly shorter break and then continue with the concert. I just want to let you know that ticket sales generally pay about 40% of what our budget is. Today it was a lot less. We would love to continue bringing these concerts here to Santa Barbara. So we would like you to help. We will be setting up donations for later. If you would like to know how you can donate through GoFundMe, we have a GoFundMe campaign that we have set up so that we can continue bringing these delightful concerts to you here at Santa Barbara. If you have to use the restroom, it's through these doors and to the fellowship hall.
In the van.
Sleeping. I'm sorry?
Sleeping in the van.
Nap time for them anyway, usually?
Yeah. Are you enjoying it?
What?
Are you enjoying this so far?
Yeah, I am. I am. I'm much more... I like opera very much, but I like the whole story.
Do you think Santa Barbara will be more welcoming for more opera, I think, is that this?
I don't know, Bobby. It's a good question. I don't have a sense of that.
Yeah.
You know, there's a symphony concert right now.
Right.
And that's where a lot of people that I know are.
Right. But also at the same time, as I think Santa Barbara can actually endure with more cultural ideas that can actually envelop more as to what just the standard bread and butter.
Yeah. No, I understand what you're saying.
I know everyone's tired of the same bread and butter. Yeah. Everyone's tired of regalado. But somehow, make something new. Get an idea or something.
Right, right. But, I'm not, I honestly don't know. Yeah. What I've been surprised about is that the Santa Barbara Opera Company, when they put on operas, they actually have a decent amount of younger people coming to those.
Interesting.
Yes. And so I don't know. Yeah. I don't know the answer.
No.
I don't have any, any real idea.
Yeah. Apparently, I don't think anyone has the right idea. But we're out here. So we're presenting and,
Yeah.
And people want to listen, people want to listen. And we're Facebook streaming live, and people, if they want to listen, they want to talk. That's great.
Well, it'll be interesting to see what kind of feedback you get from that, if any.
And we got at least five to six people viewing on and off here and there.
Uh-huh.
It was nice. And afterwards, we did the same type of streaming over in Chicago in Evanston, and it was afterwards. Is that after the live Facebook streaming, there was like over 100 views, and it just kept growing. I'm like, whoa,
that's great.
Well, yeah. So it's
let's see what happens.
Just like this, over in New York, it was just a small group.
Yeah.
And after our fourth concert, it was like, sold out.
No,
oh
kidding.
My God. No,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, it was great.
It was a 56 seat house, and we had 64 seats. And the singers were giving up their seats. But, whoa.
That's great. Yeah. So, it'll be interesting to see what the response is.
No.
I don't know.
Yeah, but overall, we're just trying to find out.
How did the concert in Hollywood go?
We're still doing that this Saturday. We had to reschedule.
Oh, you had to reschedule, so it hasn't happened yet.
No.
Okay.
So we'll reschedule this coming Saturday.
Okay.
But other than that, it's nice that singers are singing off book and off score, which is great. Yay for that. But one thing that really brings me down is that when you're a singer, you're on stage, you're an opera singer, and you're supposed to be a professional. You're singing from a book. What are you not doing?
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
The voices that you've engaged are beautiful.
Oh.
I mean, they are just incredible.
I'd like to actually try to engage in some of the older and younger voices, to see a comparison. Because maybe some older senior people like yourself that would like to actually come out of retirement would actually like to sing. And it's like, we found at least two other elderly people in New York City, and they were just phenomenal. They just come out of retirement and they sing on our concert. I'm like, that voice don't bother. It's...
So how do you advertise? Is that how do you get the voices? Or this is through your networking of people that you know already?
What we do is we start as a networking through a YouTube channel, which as administrator, I completely disgusted. What we're planning on doing is for our auditions in either March, it's for the next concert series, but we want to do our auditions over at the Church of Latter-day Saints, because mostly their community space is free to the public, and so that way we can actually bring plus me being Freemason by blood, not per choice, but that way we can actually bring singers to the student singers or all types of singers to the auditions. But he promotes what parts that we need. I just want talented singers, maybe a talented pianist. I'm more interested in a student pianist. If we get student pianist for up to 2 years. Now, college pianists, on the other hand, are looking for painter, we can't. But a student pianist.
Yeah.
Oh, it is. Yeah. And, yeah. I couldn't imagine if we found like a 5 or 8 year old pianist doing his own little thing.
And that's, oh, there's some real talent here in this area. There's no question.
There is. It's just hook, line, and fish, go out fishing, and it's...
Yeah, and see what happens.
Yeah.
Well, there's also a young opera group here, too. You know, I mean, children's opera group.
Oh, wow.
So if you could tap into that, that might bring a lot of people in.
That'd be great.
I don't know what it's called off the top of my head. But they do, some of them have parts in the Santa Barbara Opera here, and I know some people, I know one person whose son sings in that.
That would give us a lot of variant.
Yes, it would. Yeah.
And because, for now, his networking is only through YouTube, and it's like,
well, okay.
The drama. But if I had my way through the administrator's way, everything would be controlled and down at my bottom.
Well, these last two singers are fabulous.
Yeah.
I like her. I like her voice in this setting.
Yeah.
Some of the voices don't do well in this setting. But
some do, some don't.
Yeah. But anyway, that's just the way it is.
Also, we're also looking for credits, people to come by and go, oh.
Yeah.
It's hard. It's hard, but when you first get started,
it's very hard. There's no question.
Yeah.
There's no question. Anyway. Right.
Okay. All right. Be ready?
Yeah, just give me a second.
All right.
I'm going to go let them know the party. The long-awaited second half is getting ready to begin. So put your seatbelts on and buckle up, it's gonna be a show.
Do you have it paused? Do you have this paused?
This is live. They didn't hear everything you say. This is fine. That's why.
Okay.
Any other questions?
Next will be the Andrea Chenier duet, accompanied by Oliver Chen, who played the Wagner so beautifully earlier. This is the one where I was talking about Till Death Do Us Part. Thank you.
Thank you.
thank you all for coming to the concert. And please do remember us for future concerts. And remember to help us so that we can begin to continue doing concerts here. My goodness, what's the matter? I'm sorry, I couldn't resist that twisted ending. We will now have members of the Chiazza Choir of the First Congregational Church and our soloists. We're going to do an anthem called Sim Shalom by Max Chinowski. It's a hymn of peace. Sim Shalom. And that really is the last piece.
Maybe from here.
I don't have to start before.
I have to form my music. Yes.
Sim.
Thank you and good night.
Thank you.
Thank you.
To thank you to your follow words.
Oh.
No. Thank you. Take a bow. Thank you.
Thank you, followers, for seeing my concert tonight, and we'll be doing a repeat in LA on next Saturday. Thank you.